Ja. Hallo?
Hello, hello. Can you hear me?
Where are you going?
I think it cut off. My Wi-Fi was a bit, you know.
Yeah, it is Allah, brother. So what do you think, my friend? Can we
Well,
consider Muhammad a good person for a second? Not to mention he have sex with the children. He took his own son's wife. He flirted with the wife when she was married to his son. Imagine.
You flirt with the wife.
Oh yeah, he came to the house, and this is written in your book. This is written in your book. He went to the house and he
Yeah,
said to the wife, to
I seen one
Zainab.
of your videos. Yeah, I seen one of your videos about it, yeah.
Yeah, so you know it. So he flirted with the wife when the husband is not home. Do you think there is a decent man? He will do this, at least go praise, ask God for forgiveness, says God, look what I did today. He should be crying, should be, you know. No, instead, he claimed that Allah told him, why you hide what Allah he told you to take her? He claimed it is God who told him to do that. And be honest with me, if your father, with my respect to your father, or even your friend, come to your house and flirt with your wife, what you would do?
I don't know, man. But obviously, it's not a good thing to be obviously flirting with other people's wives. I know what you mean, yeah.
How Muhammad can be a prophet then? What kind of a man he go? He coming to teach us how to go to heaven? Is that how we go to heaven? And then the Muslim, they, in their book, they say that those only a privilege for the prophet. If his eyes fall into a woman, her husband must divorce her so the prophet can if her. This is the prophet of ifing, my friend. He have a privilege of ifing.
Can you show me the privileges of the prophet where you brought up that screen?
Oh, no problem. Yeah.
Bring it up,
Okay.
because obviously I don't speak Arabic. I'm not an Arabic
No, no
speaker, so.
problem. I can show you. I can give you the Arabic page. You open it, just open it, please, in Google browser. So you can use Google Translation. All right.
Right, just send it me and I'll follow it with you, yeah.
Give me a second. Here we go. This is Tafsir al-Qurtubi. I will give it, I will post it in the chat too. This is Tafsir al-Qurtubi, volume number 14, page number 187. I guess the details is so clear, right? I mean, volume, page, we have all things we need. And this is an official Islamic website. And this is the link, I'm posting it in the chat. All of you can open it and you can use Google Translation. And this is Tafsir al-Qurtubi. And I will use Google Translation.
I understand a little bit of Arabic, but not as much.
No
Not as
problem.
much
No
understanding of it.
problem.
Have
It
you seen
says
any?
here in number 10. Let us see the privilege.
All right, wait, let me have a look at it. Can you hear me?
I hear you. Give me a second. Just to be sure the page is correct. Just to be sure that this is in the page. It should be number 10. Yeah. All right. I have a difficulty with this page is flipping. I click, I will open a different website. Give me a second.
No.
All right. See, here we now we have different website. The same book anyway. The
Have you
same
posted it on the chat?
book. Yeah, this is Tafsir al-Qurtubi, variant number 14, page number 212 in this print. Here in the yellow it says, number 10, إِذَا وَقَعَ بَصَرَهُ عَلَى إِمْرَأَ وَجَّبَ عَلَى زَوْجَهَا طَلَاقُهَا وَحَلَّ لَهُ نِكَاحُهَا. This is a privilege number 10. Let us use Google Translation. Privilege number 10.
Have you posted it on the chat?
Yeah, I will pause for you in a second because this title need to be shortened. It have Arabic text in this page.
Okay.
Link shorten.
إذا وقع بصر.
Ah, here we go. You know Arabic. That's good. Very good. That will make my life easier.
زوجها طلاق وحل لكونك هو.
Here we go. This is the link. I shortened the link. Oh, it's still saying long. Hold on. Shorten the link. Okay, now. Okay, let's try this.
Is it? Have you posted it on the chat or?
Give me a second. Here we go. I'm posting it now. I just posted it.
I see it.
All right. So we go. You can open it in Google Translation. As you see here, it says interpretation of Al-Qurtubi, part number 11, variant number 11. Sorry, 14. Page number 212. And then we go to number 10. Here you see all the privilege. All of them are filthy. All the privilege is about sex and money. But then you go to number 10, which I find the most ugly, disgusting. Number 10. 10th. If his sight falls on a woman, her husband must divorce her, and it will be lawful for him to F her, not to marry her. What do you think about this?
I'm still trying to find it on the page. All right, yeah, I see it, yeah.
Number 10.
Yeah, I see it.
Hmm. What do you think about such a beautiful... Yeah.
Does it not say anything about marrying?
Well, the word nikah does not mean marry. This is a bigger one of the lies Muslims they keep repeating. With my respect to you, you are a Muslim, but you sound like an honest man, so I'm not accusing you of lying. But this is what the Muslims lie to each other, because I will show you the proof. You want to show you the proof that nikah does not mean marriage?
Nikah?
Yeah, does not mean marriage. Yeah. Do you want me to prove to you in 2 seconds that nikah does not mean marriage? 2 seconds.
I'll prove it to you.
Okay.
Go on.
If we go in the hadith, Muhammad, he says, when your wife, she have her period, do everything except nikah. So how nikah mean marriage? And they are married already. Those are women are married already. He is saying do everything except nikah. Let me get you the reference. A second. All right. Here
so
we go.
Nikah means obviously not marriage.
Are you telling me? Here we go. I will show you. You tell me what the conclusion.
I can read Arabic, but obviously.
Okay. No problem. Here we go. It says here. This is Sahih Muslim. It says here in Arabic. About this is about the Jews. The Jews, when their wife she had her period, they don't have sex with her. So Muhammad, he says, don't listen to them. اصنعوا كل شيء إلا النكاح. Do everything except intercourse. So what nikah is? Intercourse. Those are their wives already. They are married. You know?
So, because I was watching one of your videos the other day about the chapter 33 verse 50, where it says, yastankiha, something like that.
Yeah, yastankiha is a continued verb. You don't continue marrying the woman. You marry her once.
So he's saying yastankiha means
to F her. Sex. Yeah, to F her. This is the word for Fing. I mean, in front of you, my friend. Listen, you said you speak Arabic. You know how to read Arabic. Does it say here about women who they are your wife? She is not. We are not talking about a woman. She is a stranger. Does it say here, the Prophet, he said to them, when your women, they have their period, do with them, isna'u kulla shay illa nikah. Do you see it?
Yeah, I see
it. Okay. So nikah does not mean marriage. They are their wives. So he's telling them, when they have their period, do everything with them, touch them, play with them, etc., but don't do intercourse. So what nikah is? Intercourse.
Intercourse. Right, okay.
And even in the Muslim translation, they say, don't do with them intercourse when they have their menstruation. So we don't marry them because simply they are already our wives. And now they have their period. So what he said to them, do with them everything except intercourse.
Right, so over here in the tafsir you sent me, where it says here, Al-Hamis, Al-Nikahu Balafz Al-Hiba.
Yeah, a woman, she offer herself to the Prophet, Al-Nikahu Balafz Al-Hiba. So a woman, she offer herself.
Just by saying it.
Yeah, by saying, I offer you myself to sleep with me. He don't pay her. Muhammad have a privilege, he do not need to pay for sex. It's free.
Right, yeah,
only Muhammad, women, they can offer themselves to him.